In this video, we're going to explore the Linux application iceberg. We'll start with the commonly known applications and gradually move towards lesser known but very useful tools. If you're ready, let's first head to the visible part of the iceberg, where nearly everyone is familiar with these applications, though you might have missed some of their features. GIMP. GIMP is a layer-based photo editing software. It's an alternative for people who edit photos in Adobe Photoshop. It has many features and allows you to do various advanced photo editing tasks. VLC. VLC is a video playback software, but beyond video playback, it offers dozens of additional features like video conversion, connecting to remote video streams, and subtitle downloads. MPV is also a video player, but it's more popular among Linux users because you can add numerous features through scripting. For instance, with a script, MPV can automatically skip the intro when I press the tab key, or by clicking on a word in the subtitle, I can look up its meanings and create an Anki flashcard. It wouldn't be an exaggeration to call it the most customizable video player in the world. Bottles. Bottles allows you to easily run Windows software and games. It's extremely easy to understand and use. You can also back up the bottles you create and transfer them to another Linux computer with just one click. Lutris. Lutris is a tool that gathers all your games in one place. It allows you to open and organize games from various platforms like Epic Games, Steam, Ubisoft, Origin, Battle.net, and more. Beyond that, community scripts make it easy to download and run games. Heroic Games Launcher is a client designed to play Epic Games and GOG games. But didn't we just mention Lutris? Do we really need this one? Well, actually, we don't need this one, but it's a matter of preference. I personally like the speed and interface of Heroic Games Launcher, and I use this client for Epic and GOG. Pinta. Pinta is an alternative to Paint. It's handy if you need to scribble something very quickly. There are many PDF applications on Linux, but my favorite one is Ocular. It's developed by KDE. It lets you continue reading where you left off, highlight the text, and even weave the PDFs in dark mode, which is a must for me. I love dark themes. Now we're in the shallow waters, where only a few curious people have ventured. Only about 70% of people are familiar with these applications. LocalSend. LocalSend is a cross-platform file sharing tool. It allows you to send files to all devices on the same network with a single click. Much like AirDrop, but it works in every platform. It works on macOS, Windows, Android, and iOS. Metadata Cleaner. Metadata Cleaner lets you view, edit, and delete metadata from any of your files with a single click. KDE Clipboard Manager. KDE Clipboard Manager saves everything you copy on your computer, including images. You can access everything you've copied later with a shortcut you assign. You can even set the maximum amount of data it saves. Of course, each Linux desktop environment has its own clipboard manager, but KDE's version is my favorite. I don't know, I've used GNOME and their extensions. For some reason, I like KDE's better. Maybe I'm biased. KDE Connect. KDE Connect is the ultimate integration between your phone and computer. It allows many things like real-time clipboard sharing, file transfer, controlling your computer from your phone, and media control. For example, if you're watching something on your computer and get a call on your phone, the media on your computer will stop. After you finish the call, it'll play automatically. You can also read and reply to all your SMS messages from your computer. KDE Connect just enables your phone and computer to work harmoniously. LibreOffice. In my opinion, LibreOffice is the best offline office software. It's met all my needs up until now and continues to do so, but I understand some people have different needs. I don't use Office Suites that much, but whenever I do, LibreOffice is there for me. OnlyOffice. OnlyOffice is a next-gen office suite. It also works offline, and some people prefer it because it resembles Microsoft Office. Like, theme-wise, it looks like Microsoft Office. And some people consider OnlyOffice to be more compatible with Microsoft Office. But I don't know, whenever I use LibreOffice with Microsoft Office, it worked fine. Some people think OnlyOffice is better with compatibility when it comes to Microsoft Office. Thunderbird. Thunderbird is an email client. I can't say it's the best. It has its holes here and there, but I've been using it for years and it's had some nice updates recently. There are a lot of features that I use, like setting up filters, automatically moving emails with certain subjects to specific folders. I haven't found any other email client that satisfies me as much as Thunderbird. Audacity. Audacity might be the best audio editor in the world. It has hundreds of filters and settings. If you need to edit all your files, Audacity is all you need. Now we are moving to the middle of the iceberg, where less than half of people have ventured. Fewer than 50% know the applications here. KRunner. KRunner is my favorite Linux software, but unfortunately, it only works on KDE desktop. With KRunner, you can search for files or applications, view current exchange rates, search any website, view times in different time zones, perform calculations, kill applications, and many more functions that I can't even list here. I'll leave a picture for KDE users to screenshot and explore the KRunner. It has tons of features and I use it every day. Flood Seal. Flood Seal lets you manage permissions permissions for your Flatpak applications. For example, should your software have access to specific folders? Should it have internet access, microphone or camera access? You can manage all of this and more through FlatSeal. Virt Manager. Virt Manager is a tool for creating virtual machines using Chemo technology. To this date, Chemo has been the most efficient virtualization technology on my personal computer. Darktable. Darktable is an alternative to Adobe Lightroom. It allows you to edit RAW photos. TLP UI. TLP UI is essentially for laptop users as it lets you adjust the performance settings of all components. If you use TLP UI, you can optimize your battery usage and extend your laptop's lifespan. Komikku. Komikku is a comic book reading application with an excellent interface. Apostrophe is a distraction-free markdown editor with a very simple and beautiful interface. Switchero allows you to convert individual or multiple images to other formats. You can adjust many parameters from the graphical interface during conversion. Ferdium. Ferdium allows you to manage multiple messaging apps in one place. Actually, not only messaging apps, but also social media applications can be installed on Ferdium, making the Ferdium the central hub for all your communication channels. Celeste. Celeste allows you to connect services like Nextcloud, Google Drive, and Dropbox for bi-directional synchronization on your computer. Timeshift. Timeshift lets you backup your computer. You can backup to the same disk, or if you want, you can even use USB drive to backup your whole computer. SyncThing. SyncThing is a software that allows synchronization across your devices without relying on cloud service. It works not only on local network, but also over the internet. So you might ask, okay then, are our data encrypted? Yes, your data is encrypted with certificates generated on your device, so even if you use outside your local network, third-party servers cannot read your data, and whenever you have local network available, SyncThing will always prefer the local network. BleachBit. BleachBit helps you identify and delete junk and unnecessary files on your computer. KDenLive is the most advanced open-source video editor. I used it extensively in the past, but my needs have grown, so now I use DaVinci Resolve. Nevertheless, if I didn't have DaVinci Resolve, KDenLive would be my second go. Handbrake allows you to convert video formats with different resolutions and parameters through a graphical interface. Calibre. Calibre is a software for managing your ebook library. If you use not only your computer but also devices like ebook readers, Calibre will make your life significantly easier. Impression. Impression is a software for burning ISO images on Linux, much like Rufus on Windows. Ventoy is a software you can install on your USB. After installing Ventoy, you can add multiple ISO files to your USB, allowing you to keep multiple operating system installations on one USB. Hypnotix allows you to watch free IPTV channels. While it only includes known and legal free channels, you can add your own URL if you have one. Spectacle, in my opinion, is the best screenshot software on Linux. After taking a screenshot, you can add arrows, censor some sections, add texts, and you can add whatever you want. It lets you edit the screenshot you take extensively. If you want to quickly share it with a friend, you can also upload it to Imgur with just one click. Dolphin. Dolphin is my favorite file manager on Linux. It can remember sorting criteria on folder basis, it has a tab feature, and you can split the screen to view two folders at once. Right-click allows you to create custom actions, and almost every feature can be customized or assigned a shortcut. For example, when I press Alt-Shift-A in a folder, it opens a terminal window in that directory. This is a shortcut I assigned. Linux has several file managers, but my favorite one is Dolphin because it lets you customize everything. Memorize is an Anki file flashcard software designed specifically for Linux. It's written with a GTK interface and allows you to quickly create flashcards and review them later, recommended for language learners. Kate is a text and code editor. It's very similar to Notepad++, so if you're familiar with Notepad++, you should definitely install Kate. It's highly customized, has a modern interface, and supports numerous plugins. Now we're in the deep waters, where only 20% of people know and use these applications. Easy Effects. Easy Effects allows you to apply global effects to your microphone or audio output on Linux. Sometimes people ask me, you know, why my microphone sounds so good. The answer is actually Easy Effects. With Easy Effects, I always have global noise reduction, gate, and compressor plugins on my microphone. This ensures that my voice sounds great no matter which software I use. It's not just OBS or anything. I will go into any call and Easy Effects will do its magic. My effects will be the same. And by the way, this is not just limited to your microphone. You can apply multiple settings to your speakers, save them as presets, and switch to them with a single click. Alpaca is a desktop client that allows you to use text-based AI models. It's designed to be simple for users, and if you're looking for an AI system that works completely offline on your computer, Alpaca is a great choice. Upscaly is a software that lets you increase the resolution of your images. It works entirely offline and has various parameters that you can adjust for fine-tuning. Fan Control allows you to manage all of the fans on your computer, and you can set conditions for different situations. For example, you can set it to run at a certain speed when the temperature reaches a specific threshold. Green with Envy is a tool for monitoring and controlling fan speeds on NVIDIA graphic cards. Kafka scans your entire system at a lightning speed to find duplicate files, and allows you to delete the duplicate ones if you wish. But you might ask, you know, why would I have duplicate files on my computer? Well, you should run a scan duplicate and see for yourself. Sometimes, you know, you don't remember those duplicates, but they're there. Lossless cut allows you to cut video files without re-encoding them. This is extremely useful if you don't want to go to an editing software and cut a specific place. And by the way, this preserves the quality of the video. So it cuts, it preserves the quality of the video. Sometimes though, cuts are not precise like an editing software, but still you don't have to re-encode them. And if you don't need them to be perfect, then that's great. You can use this software. I use it all the time. Not for my main videos, but some other videos that I edit. Text Pieces is designed specifically for developers. It lets you perform various text processing tasks, such as calculating hashes, encoding and decoding text, removing line breaks, and formatting JSON and XML. You can also expand the app by writing your own scripts. Peak is a screen recording tool with a unique feature. It allows you to save your recordings as GIFs. Waydroid allows you to run Android in a container on Linux. It performs much faster than any Android emulator you've ever used. Waydroid integrates Android apps very well into your system. When you click an Android application, it opens them in a separate window as if they were a native application. Now we've reached the very bottom, where less than 10% of people know or use these applications. OnionShare. OnionShare allows you to send files through the Tor network, and it also lets you host a website on Tor. It's a very unique tool. I know not everybody will need this kind of tool, but you know, it's still a good application. Mosai. It listens to music through your microphone or directly from your speakers and finds the song for you. Mosai also keeps a history of songs that you identified before. Audio sharing allows you to share your audio from your Linux desktop to other computers. Identity allows you to compare the quality of multiple image or video files. It splits the screen into 2, 3 or more sections depending on how many files you uploaded to. And when you zoom into one section, all sections zoom simultaneously, making it easy to compare quality differences. Sterling PDF is an open source version of I Love PDF. It enables you to perform all PDF editing tasks offline. That is an enhanced version of the cat command in the Linux terminal. It includes syntax highlighting, making files much easier to read and understand. Analysis CPP. This software monitors processes on your system and assigns priorities based on the predefined categories. For example, it can assign a higher priority to your browser and a lower priority to your background task, making your system more responsive, and when it comes to games, make games more smooth. Systemd OMD is designed to automatically kill applications that suddenly start consuming too much memory. Why? Well, because if your memory usage maxes out, your system will freeze and you'll need to restart your computer. So Systemd OMD prevents such problems from happening. Gamescope is a compositor developed by Valve. When you launch games through Gamescope, you can adjust various parameters, making your games run smoother. This technology is also used in Steam Deck. Game Mode allows you to prioritize processes for gaming. However, if you're already using Analysis CPP that we just mentioned, you don't need to use game mode simultaneously because Analysis is already doing its prioritizing. Pinocchio AI Browser enables you to install various AI tools on your system with a single click, with no coding knowledge required, or if you've never used anything like Docker or whatever, you don't need to use any of those. With Pinocchio, you can just click install and it'll install. You can try out a wide range of AI tools, from subtitle generation to face swapping and voice cloning. And all of this will work on your machine offline. Micro Text Editor. Micro is a terminal-based text editor and might be the most user-friendly one for Linux newcomers, but not everybody knows this. Unlike traditional terminal editors with complicated shortcuts, Micro has intuitive key bindings that make it easy to use. For example, Ctrl+S saves the file. You can quit with Ctrl+Q, and this is way better for newcomers. But of course, no matter what, in my personal life, I will still continue using Vim. Wireshark allows you to monitor all incoming and outgoing network connections on your computer. It's a powerful network analysis tool. Portmaster is kind of similar to Wireshark, not exactly the same, but it's kind of does some similar things. Also, Portmaster has a simpler interface. It has different features like DNS over HTTPS, and you can use Portmaster as a firewall. Power Level 10K allows you to theme your ZSH shell to your preference. It's easy to install and highly recommended for ZSH users. Piper enables you to easily assign buttons and customize your gaming mouse. LSD is an enhanced, more readable version of the LS command in the terminal. It includes icons and colors and allows you to click on files to open them directly. Well, there you have it. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you want to see content like this more, you can leave a subscription or, you know, leave a like and comment and tell me what recommendation you have for me or which applications that you didn't know and helped you. You can write all of that in the comments. I will be reading them. And yeah, see you on the next video. Bye-bye.